voters. So we can create voters. Program like this, I mean like I photograph to create voters. Program like this can create some more voters, can influence more people towards natural world. So it's a great job. I would like to congratulate for that. And secondly, my second goal is, of course, I would like to contribute for the science. My photo helps science. It's a great help. I mean, I feel it's a successful image. And in many cases, I work with scientists and researchers. And my takeaway was I learned a lot from them. Because I'm not from that background. I was from physics actually. No relation with zoology and this thing. Absolutely a mathematical guy. So anyway, come to the subject. This is I think most of you have seen images from Narkondam. So this image is from Narkondam. This is Narkondam Island. And actually I went there with Dr. Rahmani and Dr. Shirish Manchi. Shirish Manchi was working on Narkondam Hornbill. So I get a chance to be with them. And I stayed there for 18 days in the island. Actually, we were dropped by the Coast Guard and then collected from there, after 18 days. There is a police camp, only a police camp, where we used to stay and get our food. And landing is very difficult. It's a very fragile island, small, tiny island, 6.8 square kilometer island. It's a dormant volcano. And not very easy to move inside the island. You can't do a dry landing even. So you have to get down in the water. So, as usual, when I landed, I don't do photography. When I reach somewhere, so I try to understand the place and understand the situation and the subject. So I spent 2-3 days to see the situation, and I found that this was March and it was breeding season. So hornbills were busy making nest, breeding displays, and you go to next. So this is a male hornbill, male Narkondam hornbill. So you can see I actually photographed from the bottom. So I found one tree. This is a ficus tree where many Narkondam hornbills used to come for food. And because there is not much disturbance, birds were comfortable. But you can see this photo is from the bottom, so you can see it's a belly. So the basic rule for photography is there is nothing called good images or bad images. It has to be different. So the way we see things, actually, if we can show them in a different way, then it becomes attractive, so that people will be forced to see it. So we are habituated to see those birds which are canopy dwellers like this from bottom. So there is no surprise, it's like a one photo. So I thought, because I identified the tree, so I planned to be on the top next. Next. So I climbed the tree and made a setup like this. My camera is there. So I spent the whole day there and observing the behavior of the bird and got interesting images. Next. So I used to sit there. So this is just 40-50 feet above the ground, and that was my daily routine, to sit there for 5-6 days. I did that. Next. So I used to climb down like this. So I had a rope, and finally, so I got this. Like, this is a female hornbill photo. Next. So like this. So it's different angle, the male. Next. So another male, I think. And I got a photo like this where I can show the habitat. You can see the sea, it defines it's an island. And it's not, the bird is not important, but you can see the entire environment. Then, next, and I got a male female together also. So this is, you can see the back, this is a different angle. There was actually, they were nesting nearby, and So I was on the same tree where they were feeding, but in the tree where they made the nest, it was, if I climbed that tree, that was that would be the very, you know, disturbing for their nesting activities. So for nesting bird, I decided to fix a rope in a tree a little far from the tree where they were making the nest, and I used some different techniques next. So it was like that. So there was a nest. So I was in another tree close to that, and next. So it was like that to get the proper angle. Next. Next. And then I got this image there. Next.
Who took the photographs of you?
I actually, I was carrying another wide angle, so I took a selfie. I've become a selfie expert. Yeah. So these are the cases from Nakundam. Go to the next folder. So next, another research project. I was in Pilibhit, working on a very rare species called rare and difficult to photograph, Bengal Florican. So you know, so basically I was with the BNHS team, where two researchers were there. Dr. Ramani also was there. The area where I was working, three individuals actually were there, and there was a plan to put PTT transmitter on two birds, and one bird was left. I mean, there was no plan to put PTT on that. So what I did, I was observing the bird. I made a hide. It was a complete grassland, and I made a hide inside the grassland with the help of the natural staff, completely camouflaging with the background. And every day I used to see the bird. So this is the grassland, kind of grassland in Pilibhit Tiger Reserve. And from the hide, I started sitting on the hide for I sat there for 8 days. So the first few days I was getting shorter. Next, like you know this, so the bird was far, it was not coming close to me, and because I had some photos like this. And the interesting part was this grassland had one tigress with three cubs. So every day morning I used to enter into the hide at 4 o'clock, completely dark in the morning, and I was alone. No torch, nothing, because I didn't want to disturb the habitat. So it was a little scary because everywhere I could hear the growling sound of the tigress, and sometimes the alarm calls. They were very close. So that was a kind of experience I used to have that time. But while doing this, I was not getting impressive shots. So this was an experience. I mean, this is an example of sometimes you get to know a lot of things when you spend time in the field. Next. So I was photographing this, one day I was photographing this black francolin, and because I have a deforest and it has a continuous shutter sound like trrr, trrr. So you know, so when I was photographing this bird, one florican was a little away, and I saw that that bird became a little excited, because actually when they display, they create the same sound. So it's like the wing flapping, trrr, trrr. So that the shutter sound was similar to their display sound. So that male thought, so another male has come in its territory, and it becomes excited. So I thought, this is a nice lead I got. So I just stopped my shooting and came back. So because we were put PTT in the floricans. We had to catch the bird. For that, we were carrying a dummy florican. Go to next. So we had a dummy florican like this. And next day, I mean, actually that day evening, what I did, I just close to hide, I set this dummy, and I went, and next day I came at 4 o'clock. Then what I did, when I saw the mail, I started clicking false starter, and that bird, I mean, within 30 seconds that bird flew and just come close to this bird, and I get, I mean, very close shots of floating the nest. So it was that close. And that was on the 8th day. So it was very interesting. Yeah, so next, so this was the Bengal Florican thing, and next story was, you know, in 2007-8, I was trying to photograph black pheasant and Saddle Crossbar in Single Hill National Park. I was spending, that time I don't know, this is, it becomes a little easier, but that time it was quite difficult. I spent 40 days in Single Hill National Park, and, you know, in 40 days, I managed to get some images of black pheasant, but couldn't manage this Saddle Crossbar. But I tried a lot. I tried for the bird, and every day morning to evening, I used to get their call, because in the morning they give calls during because it was April and May breeding season. They are quite active that time. So that was 2007-8. Finally, in 2013, so that was 40 days. And in 2013, I was just there in the same time. And in 4 days, actually, I got some very interesting images, because I knew the road, I knew the area, and I tried. But why I'm telling this thing? Because people can think this is a result of that 4 days. It is not true. This is actually the result of that 40 days and plus this 4 days. Then I got this shot, because I followed the bird, I started the behavior next. And these male were actually fighting, so they were so engrossed in the fight, they ignored me. So I got very close shot. This is a full frame with 400 to 0.81, that not very, you know, a long focal length. Next. They were fighting. And fighting. Next. Next story is the ducks. I think everyone has seen this. I was thinking, should I show this or not, because you may get bored. But this is also interesting. I think, I mean, if someone has not seen this. Oh no, this is Saraswati thing. Okay. So I was working on a book for UP government, I mean forest department, on sparrow cranes. So it's a very interesting species, because they live with the people. So I'm showing these images, because I want to tell, I mean, how I thought that time. So this is a nesting image of sparrow crane. What they made, they generally make nest very close to human habitat. So they are very much they live together with the human being. So I thought, let's photograph those angles, how they live with them. Next. So I tried to photograph this kind of frames, where it shows the relationship. You can see the, basically they are farmers, and they are foraging in paddy field. Next, like this. So they are mating friends, and you see they make nests very close to the village. You can see every activity is there, so people are very comfortable. They are also comfortable. Then this is very close to a highway. You can see the trucks are going along the road.
Okay.
Same place. Yeah, next. So these are the, I mean, I'm not showing the general images where it's like the very crisp and sharp image of one sparrow, rather the relationship between the people and the and the Bharat. Next, what I was telling that the tasks thing. So this is also old work. I was working on a book on Dibru-Sekwa National Park. So this is a wetland in close to Dibru-Sekwa. This is called Mahuri wetland. This is connected with Brahmaputra River. So this is during winter, January, and I had no nice angled, you know, the dark image. So I was trying to get them close. So what I did, this is the kind of habitat. Here also you can see lots of fishermen net and people are there. So I made a hide next. I made a hide like this to get images. And wait. So I was getting images like this, but I was not happy because not many birds were coming close to me. Somehow, I don't know why. So while sitting in the hide, I used to observe the pattern of their flight, their roosting time, where they are moving. So every day I used to see. So this I did for 14 days, and in 7-8 days I realized in one time, say around 3:30, what entire flock actually used to fly in a particular place, which is close to some water hyacinth, and you know, it was a very, very daily. I mean, it was a daily routine actually. I mean, there was no other thing happened. Every day they flew to that particular area. So I changed my plan. So then I decided next to I wanted to be inside the water hyacinth. So that's the area where the front where the entire flock used to come. And next, so I sat like this, and I generally I got into the water around 1:30, so that just 1.5 hours before the expected time, and it was really very cold. And next, so the situation was like that, and you know, so this time only long lens was there. So one day I thought I should keep a wide angle also. Because what I realized when the ducks landed, no, it's very, they were so close from me. I mean, it's like just 1-2 feet. I could hear some, you know, unreal sounds which I never heard of, and they used to drop on my head and anything. And so I thought, let's keep a wide angle. Now, when you are in the water in that day, your hand, you have to be very careful. You can't put, like you are holding a camera, you have to forget and just put your hand inside and camera is gone. Next. So I put a pot there like this. So floating pot, and I put another wide angle camera there. So that if I make a mistake, the camera will survive. And finally I got some interesting image next. So this VGR. No, I mean, these days, I mean, people have this image. This is not a great image. So, on this context, I just want to share something. So, wherever I go, some people come to me and say, I like your images. I heard, and then I take his name and I go back. I check their images in the internet. And every time I found, everyone has more surprising image than me. But still, they are loving me. The people are fantastic. So, I mean, everyone has much better images than me. But still, they like my image. I don't know why. Next. Next. And that was that with that wide angle in the where I was. Next subject I would like to share is like evolution of thought somewhere. This is a very old photo of mine of Monal. This is also very long back. There was no good photo of Monal. This is in Kedarnath Wildlife Sanctuary. So very hard work, and you know, I had to say it hide, but foggy. I mean, it was not good quality image, but that time it was nice. I mean, then I started working on Monal, and with time, so I wanted to take photo in snow because there